everyone. In this video, we are going to be walking through a quadratic spline interpolation example. If you missed our previous video on the theory of quadratic interpolation, I will leave a link in the description down below for you. Our first question tells us that we need to find all the relevant interpolating functions between the following data using quadratic spline interpolation. The first thing that I'm going to do is go ahead and plot our data points so that we can better visualize what we are being asked to solve. Plotting the data that we were given looks like this. It is clear that there are going to be three splines that we are going to have to find, which makes sense as our number of splines, n, will always be one less than the number of data points that we are given. As we learned in our quadratic spline theory video, we are going to have 3n unknowns. Therefore, we are going to have 9 unknowns and therefore need 9 equations to find all of our necessary unknowns. Before we get into solving this problem, I'm just going to go ahead and develop a plan to find our solution. The first thing that we are going to do is write out our quadratic functions for all three of the interpolating polynomials that we wish to find. Secondly, we will identify our 9 unknowns within our functions, so that you can visualize what we are going to be finding. Thirdly, we are going to be presented with a system of equations that we will solve and find all of our unknowns. Then, lastly, once we have our whole system solved, we just need to plug in our x inputs for the second part of the question. Let's begin solving. As we said, the first step that we are going to do is write out our interpolating polynomials. Using quadratic interpolation, each of these equations are simply second-order polynomials, which look like this. Our second step is to identify our 9 unknowns, which is simply all the coefficients, which I will highlight here. Now, we need to find our 9 independent equations to solve for our 9 unknowns. As we learned in the last video, we can get 2n equations through evaluating each of our 3 polynomials at our known data points. So let's just go ahead and do that. To elaborate a bit more, we are going to evaluate our first polynomial with its 2 data points, so x1 and x2. P2 will be evaluated at x2 and x3, and lastly, P3 will be evaluated at x3 and x4. As you can see, this results in our 6 equations, which I will highlight here in number. Secondly, again, as we learned in our quadratic interpolation theory video, we can find n-1 equations through the property of smoothness at our interior data points, which in this example will give us 2 more equations, as we have 2 interior data points. To find these, we are going to evaluate the derivatives and evaluate them at their shared x value. Therefore, to get our first equation here, we are going to take the derivatives of p1 and p2, evaluated at x2. This works out to the following equation. Secondly, we will repeat this process for our second interior data point. Therefore, we will evaluate the derivative of p2 and p3, and evaluate them at x equals x3. And this results in the following equation. Now, as you can see, we have 8 equations. We are still missing an equation to solve for our 9 unknowns, though. At this point, it is common to assume the first point's second derivative is equal to 0, and thereby assume that our first polynomial is actually linear interpolation, as the assumption assumes 0 curvature. However, if you're writing a test or just using quadratic interpolation, you may be given or assume a better assumption. If so, obviously use that and not this assumption. However, for me, in this example, this assumption is the best option. Therefore, our final equation works out to the following. Now that we have our 9 equations, we can solve for all 9 of our unknowns. To do this, we could try doing it manually. However, this would not be fun. We have all linear equations, and therefore, we have what is called a system of linear equations. Therefore, we can use one of our linear system of equation solvers that we developed previously. So, let's just write out a matrix so that we know what we are trying to solve. You can think of all these columns as our coefficient values for each of our equations. I will write that out here so you can better visualize it. Now, I am going to use our Gauss elimination solver with partial pivoting that we developed in a previous numerical methods video. I will leave a link to that video down in the description down below. However, there are systems of linear equation solvers online that you can find by simply Googling them. Now that we are inside Python, I'm just going to take a minute and enter our matrix into two variables, as that is how I wrote this Gauss elimination solver function. Now, we just need to call our function and insert our variable matrix and then our constant matrix. And as you can see, we have now solved for the 9 unknowns. Each of these x values represents a coefficient for our 3 interpolating polynomials. x0 is a1, x1 is b1, x2 is c1, x3 is a2, and so on. Applying these 3 equations to our interpolating polynomials results in the following equations. To visualize these polynomials, I'm just going to plot them rather crudely inside Microsoft Excel. This results in the following graph, and as you can see, our first interpolating polynomial is a linear spline as we previously mentioned. Now, back on our blackboard, we can begin solving the second question that we were asked. We were asked to evaluate the interpolating polynomials at inputs of 2, 4, and 7. Quickly, I'm just going to write out our polynomials in their respective domains. For an input of 2, we're going to be using our first interpolating polynomial based on our domains. This results in an output of 2.5. Secondly, for an input of 4, that falls in the domain of our second interpolating polynomial. This results in an output of 4.75. Lastly, for an input of 7, we will use our third interpolating polynomial. This results in an output of 13.15, and we have now answered all the questions that we were asked. I hope this video helped your understanding of how we go about solving problems using quadratic spline interpolation. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.